Hello.
And welcome to my channel. I'm Sig Soto. Welcome to Tiny Tuesday Tryout number 51. And today I have a special razor, but a very much more special brush. I'll show you the razor first. It's the Mueller Rocker XL. XL? You might think. I've never heard of that. You might think too. Well, this is. I found a vendor, a seller online, shop, selling replacement top caps and base plates for the Rocker. So I paid 17 and a half for the top and $17.50 for the base plate. So $35 for the head. I couldn't resist, I just ordered it. And then it got here, and of course I only have one Mueller stainless steel handle, and that's the one for the R41GS. So that's why I have this huge handle on it. 14 millimeters wide. Total length of this is 4.25 inch. The weight of it is 119 grams. So it's a heavy duty brother. The soap for today is this very special soap. The John Paul Jones soap from Heritage Hill. It's a wonderful, wonderful soap. It has, says here on the lid, let's see, bay rum, teakwood, cedar, bergamot, and patchouli. You see, it says here. So there's no guessing. I get the teakwood, I get the bergamot, I get the cedar, the patchouli, not so much. The bay rum, oh yeah, that's there in the background. So I'm not a huge bay rum fan, but this is just there in the background, you know, supporting the other actors. So it's a supporting actor in this soap. It's a 3 ounce puck, tallow based, and it's a $10 soap. So 3.33 out of the for every soap sold, they give 5%, and that's 50 cents, to a foundation supporting military veterans and veteran law enforcement officers. So, and I like that, being a veteran and all. So the brush for today is this very very special brush. This is the Rich Man shaving brush made by Rich Hansen. I contacted him a good while back. We talk from time to time. He's my friend. I contacted him and said I would like a pearl white handle. And then I explained to him why, told him the story. And he said, well, when I get the right pour, I'll make it for you. So he gave it some shots. He had other stuff to do. And then finally, he mailed me. Look at this. I prefer this. It's called the Shorty, I think. This style of handle, I have, this is my third or fourth of these. So I finally got it. So here it is. The very special story behind this handle and why it has to have that color is between me and Rich. He knows the story. So, but it's a very, so this is now officially my most special brush. So Rich, thank you for getting this to me. Thank you for making this. I'm so glad. So, I would say only a 4 out of 10. So it's a mildly scented soap, at least in the bowl. Man, look at this. Oh yeah, and when you put it on the face, it's immediately a 5. So I don't know why that is. Well, it's closer to my face. I know. So, man. Oh man, I've been looking forward to using this brush. Man. Finally got it. Thank you, Rich. Being such a great guy. love this handle. I love the look of this. I love the story behind it. I'm honored and grateful to call you my friend, Rich. So, in it, I forgot to tell you, 7 o'clock black Gillette on the third use. See, two dots. So this will be the third use. Let's give it a go. So. This soap, the John Paul Jones, is regarded by many as the founder of the American US Navy. He started off as a pirate, and then he was asked to fight in helping the country. Then he became a patriot, and then he helped form the American Navy. So by many, he's regarded as the founder, as I just said, of the American Navy. And he has a very famous quote from a battle. He was asked to surrender. They were surrounded and without much chance. And he said, he responded, I have not yet begun fighting. And then the battle at sea with the ship, of course, cannons and stuff, started. And even though the ship he was on ended up sinking, they won the battle. So he's an American hero. Just like, and I told Rich that, just like Rich is to me. He is a hero to me. He's a friend. He's a stand-up guy. If you haven't seen his brushes before, go to Etsy. I will leave a link below to Rich's Etsy page. Just know this, whenever he has a brush drop, they are usually gone within a couple of minutes. He is the inventor of the Blood Oath brush with the razor blade inside. And a lot of other great brushes. And one of the things, when you get a brush, like this fantastic one from Rich, that's the only one. He doesn't make two brushes that are the same. So you get a unique brush. And there's always something. Sometimes they have a name, sometimes they don't. I already told Rich that I would call this Gandalf the White, because it has magic, and I'm a big Tolkien and Lord of the Rings fan. So, another hero, you might say. So, I talked to Rich about which razor to use, and I suggested this, and he says, this is, you know, it's so big that you could actually use it to fight if you had to. So that's kind of in the theme of today, right? Against the growth on the second pass, as I have come to enjoy, I have a 2.5 day stubble. I don't know if you hear. You have the blade here. I have every direction of growth here on my neck. So I need to go around the same place, you know, multiple times. This is a nice razor. It's very heavy, which helps me. I like a heavy razor. I like a fat handle. This is a 14 millimeter handle. I like a heavy razor, 119 grams. So, everything about this bargain is fantastic. Oh yeah, the company is in Denmark, so if you want to order from them, you will pay. A huge amount for shipping. So, and that's why I'm not putting the link to the shop down below, because you might pay 35 for this, but then you pay 80 for shipping, and then you still have to add your own handle. So it's a nice razor. A lot of, well, not a lot, but some blade feel. I like that. It tells me where the cutting edge is, and it's easy to find. Doesn't have leather holes. So a lot, some people have criticized this for clogging up all the time, but that was not a problem for me today, obviously. Okay, so let's wash the face with the yellow face cloth. Let me just remove some of the excess beards here. Okay, get over. So, yeah, that's nice, 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 nice. There is also a Facebook group called Rich Man Shaving. So I will leave a link to it, and you can go in there and you can see some of the magnificent brushes that he has dropped, because he always presents them in there when he drops on Etsy. So you can go in there and follow. Bossman Accessory, Hendrix Classics and Co. What do you call it? Towel? Yeah. Oh yeah, that's nice. Let me just have a look. Oh yeah. That's perfect. Okay. I have this Protect and Care 2-in-1 Nivea Aftershave. And I believe somebody said or wrote somewhere that it's being discontinued. You shake it and then it becomes all, you know, muddy inside it. I think this contains alcohol, because that's how it smells. I'm not sure. Oh yeah. Definitely some alcohol in this. Nice. Oh yeah. Soft. Something soothing. Okay. So I have a nice, nice, nice skin. I'm not even sure I need the final thing I have for today, but I will be doing it because I prepared it. I have this, the Nivea Aftershave Balm, the Sensitive Cool. So, never tried this, I think. I don't remember, but I expect to get a little kick from it, because cool usually means some kind of menthol or eucalyptus or cooling ingredient. very... I shouldn't have taken that much, that's for sure. Oh yeah. So, let me just wash my hands. Okie dokie. That was a wonderful shave. So the razor for today was the Miele Rocca XL, as I call it. The soap was the John Paul Jones from Heritage Hill blade. Gillette Super Platinum 7 o'clock black. I used the Greenlandic Elemental Cup to soak. I used the Nivea Men Sensitive Cool Balm at the end. Before that, I used the 2-in-1 aftershave, also from Nivea. Then I used the Six Solo white shaving ball. And finally, and most importantly, I used this wonderful, wonderful brush, Gandalf the White, I call it, made by Rich Hansen, Rich from Rich Man Shaving. So thank you for watching. And that's it. Like, subscribe, hit the bell and share. And you know why we do this? We do this because we are not obsessed. We are dedicated. Six Solo out.